Pavlovich. West, an open jumper. Ilgauskas knocked out of his hands by Pierce. House falls down. Left side's on him. They blew the whistle. Little extra pushing and shoving. It's going to be a hell ball. House taken out by Kenny Maurer. And again, we talked about this from the start. You're not controlling your emotions. Normally in these situations, you see double technicals handed out. Let's see how this veteran crew deals with this. We're back to the bench, guys. Doc Rivers telling Eddie House to get away. Chance of Eddie. West does the right thing. He dives on him. And they just wouldn't stop after hearing the whistle. Double technicals have been handed out. Doc Rivers likes the emotion House has brought out. But you got to control it sometimes. Right now, though, Boston in control. They're up by a dozen here in the second. 12, time for the Coors Light Cool Tracks. You want to get into a game seven? You want to win a basketball game? Well, how bad do you want to do it? Take a look at Eddie House defending the basketball, not quitting on the play, tracking the ball, help position. Well, whose house is it? It's Eddie House. Good job of diving for the loose ball, keeping the ball alive, and sending a message to everybody in the building. We will not lose because of lack of energy, effort, and passion. Eddie House was a second-round pick out of Arizona State way back in 2000, played his first 3 years with the Heat, but he's played for eight teams in the last 5 years, bouncing around. Miami, the Clippers, Charlotte, Milwaukee, Sacramento, Phoenix, New Jersey, and now his first year in Boston, signed as a free agent back in August. They love his locker room presence as well. He's one of those guys, he's always upbeat. He always has energy.
But no one has trusted him yet consistently in the playoffs. Everyone plays him in his role in the regular season. This may be his personal breakthrough for someone to trust him throughout the playoffs.
He was a big-time scorer in college. He's instant offense off the bench. Had some good seasons with Phoenix when the Suns were advancing in the playoffs. A real spark. He can score points in a hurry. Speaking of that, LeBron James back to two as his foot was on the line. He's not a pure point guard, and he's only 6'1". He's a shooting guard in a point guard's body, as I like to say.
When you think about that, how many pure point guards are there? You got to let this guy play basketball. Pierce has the ball in his hand. We'll put Eddie House in position to catch and shoot.
Pierce will go to the line for two more. Pavlovich picks up his second. And again, Pierce, who usually amongst the NBA leaders in getting to the free throw line, it has not been the case as much with the exception of game five. But getting to the free throw line for the first time today. LeBron James having a little courtside chat with some fans here along the sideline as he gets the first. NBA playoffs on ESPN continue Tuesday night on ESPN at 8 Eastern. The NBA draft lottery and then game one of the Eastern Conference Finals. It's either going to be Detroit here in Boston or Cleveland in Detroit. And Pierce knocks down the second one. 12-point lead with 5 minutes to play in the second. Pistons getting a lot of rest while they watch these two teams go at each other. Wallace, Pavlovich, bumped by Pierce, count it and one. Up move from Pavlovich, and he's got a chance for a three-point play.
Good aggressive move by Pavlovich, but you see the problem with having Ben Wallace on the floor offensively. He does not have to be defended. There's no concern about him scoring, but give Pavlovich credit. Catches the basketball in position to attack, gets the foul, and the basket.
It's been an injury-riddled year for Pavlovich. You mentioned that ankle injury late in the regular season. Wearing that brace around the left ankle. He can score. Good three-point shooter, can take it to the basket. Nice feed, Anderson inside. Paul Pierce doing a little bit of everything. Yeah, that's